Good morning. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. All my co-principals, leadership team members, and all teachers, staff, my well wishers. I am Mohammed Shujauddin from Success Star School, Salala, Kotapet, Balapur Mandal, Rangareddy District, Hyderabad. Today, my topic, which I was sharing in many of the discussions, is nothing more than what is this and what is the impact of this online classes, especially for our low budget schools here. So to start with, I'll take first students into consideration. Many students don't have smartphones or laptops to attend online classes or get work on WhatsApp. In some cases, even schools haven't figured things out. Many poor families studying in these low budget schools here in our area are staring at disruptions in their studies without access to mobiles, internet or laptops or even desktops, even as privileged students. So all this is happening in private schools and online classes amid with this coronavirus lockdown. So now we started teaching in Zoom app, but most of the students in primary and middle schools are struggling as they have either no access to assignments or find it virtually impossible to study mathematics and many other subjects through WhatsApp or any other platforms. Government issued orders on paper to school principals and teachers to assign work online, but the ground reality is quite different. When I interacted with many of my parents, I understood that they are struggling to bridge the digital gap. Many families do not have smartphones, let alone computers or laptops. Some said they don't know how to use the Zoom, WhatsApp, while some parents are engaged in essential services and need to take their only phone with them on their duties. Now, talking about teachers, teachers have not received their salaries, and this is also a challenge in involving them for these online sessions and are finding it difficult to make ends meet amid the lockdown. Even we help them in various kind of situations, like for example, we motivated them and we have called them. We also helped them in distributing the ration kits. However, there are constraints, like a household with three students having just one phone. If we are lucky and it is a short disruption, we will need excellence from our teachers to fill this gap. But if the disruption carries on for longer, we will have to find smarter ways to enable remote learning and not just online learning. Schools in the private sector and others have already started work on building remote learning resources and have been trying to build student engagement. We are all new to this version of remote learning, so we will all have to work harder to prevent a big learning gap between the rich and the poor. I don't know how many have gone through this article where UNESCO has also pointed out that disrupting schooling can also lead to other harder to measure losses, including inconvenience to families and decreased economic productivity as parents struggle to balance work obligations with childcare. So keeping all this into view, today, my feeling, or I really oppose online classes on seeing, because when the situation is like this, even parents are saying that, and even I am observing that mobile phones, if we see continuously for an hour, for 1 hour, it makes headache. And after completing only for that, then only sleep is coming. I feel education in India must be equally reached to all rich, poor, middle and upper classes without any differentiation, providing one single board of syllabi or syllabus. So at the present situation of COVID-19, is it possible?